do you think future of like a Mission Impossible, do you want maybe want something more back to old roots sort of thing, where the first movie was like more spy thriller, more there was more of that like tension in the movie where you weren't sure, like no one had plot armor, but or have they elevated the action so much that it's too hard to then go back to something more subdued and grounded?
It's a tough call. I think that Mission Impossible is kind of like Fast and Furious, but just not as, it's not at that level of stupidity yet. It's not Vin Diesel like jumping out of a tank and landing on a car and just being like, lucky the car broke my fall.
Playing Rocket Leagues with like Dodge cars and stuff.
Yeah, like it's not at that level. It's still at the fun, but like, there's consequences and people die.
They're still derailing trains and jumping off huge ramps and climbing Burj Khalifas though. So it is still almost comical.
I think because Tom Cruise actually does the shit, it gives it this impressiveness that you actually look at it like, whoa.
Yeah.
Like in the trailer, that moment where the bike goes off the cliff, you know that Tom Cruise did that. When you look at the behind the scenes, he didn't just do it once either. He did it like multiple takes.
Yeah.
So when you see it, you have this gasp of like, I can't believe he actually did it. Whereas when you see that crap in Fast and Furious, you're like, well, it's obvious. Like it looks fake as, and you know that Vin Diesel definitely ain't jumping off no cliff with a bike.
I wonder what his next impressive stunt will be. But I just wonder, this is his like maybe the 15th time he does it. It's still impressive, but it's... people kind of maybe will write it off as, oh, it's just yet another thing. The magic sort of worn off. Oh, it's just yet another Daredevil stunt in a bid to try and rake in the audience to the theaters and so on.
I don't know. Maybe he'll...
it's like a sort of John Wick effect where people sort of like are bored by it. It's like, well, you can only do all these impressive stunts and choreography so many times before.
Well,
it's kind of starting to all blur.
This is where it gets to the point where you go, if the next Mission Impossible is the last one, then that would be great. Because then it's like, yes, just ride off into the sunset, never come back. But it was a good franchise. You had your like one movie that was not good, but out of like 7, 8 movies, that's pretty solid.
It's been going on for 20 years or something, hasn't
it? Yeah, since like, since 96, since I was like 1 year old.
But like ever since like the first movie, the amount of like action, it just like keeps escalating. And so maybe then the solution is after part two, that's when they like... end the franchise on a high note, because after that it's starting to reach maybe a point of diminishing returns. Then how much more stunts has he got in him? How much more can audience be bought into the spectacle of it?
If it was anyone else, I'd say
there's the Tom Cruise effect.
But because it's Tom Cruise, I'm like, nah, he's gonna go to space and then he's gonna free flow from a rocket ship and then just fucking crash into the earth and get up from
He does a reinvention of his acting career in a way that emulates Jackie Chan's, where it's like after the golden age of Hong Kong cinema, he can only do death-defying stunts for so long before the magic wears off and there's only so much their body can take. Maybe then they go more into dramatic arts and stuff, because Tom Cruise actually has acting chops and comedy chops as well, and like Tropic Thunder and so on. So maybe after that, that's the trajectory he'll take his sort of acting portfolio into. So maybe that'll be interesting to see after like Dead Reckoning Part 2.
That actually would be a good way of him riding off into the sunset. He just retires the franchise and goes, you know what? I'm going to do comedy. Or I'm going to get back into serious dramatic stuff. Kind of like Robert Downey Jr. He can do stuff where he's not even recognizable. Reinvent himself.
Yeah,
it's fun way to like spend your like later years after.
Yeah, twilight of your acting career. You get stuck in just doing action for so long. Maybe you start forgetting like the roots of like, you know, what got them into acting in the first place.
Yeah.
Something more slow burny. I don't know. Maybe he could be doing that.
I mean, the twilight of his career would be like the peak of a normal person's career.
Doing
like,
instead of
doing a $500 million movie, I'm now doing a $300 million
movie. Because how old is he? 60?
60 something.
Yeah, gosh, he doesn't look a day like over 30 or something. You know?
Oh, dude, that fucker can run. Like, he could run circles around me. I got tired just watching him run.
Boundless energy.
So
that's Dead Reckoning Part 1, which, as we said, it's like, despite you enjoying it so much, it could have done with a more delayed release so as to really reach its full box office potential. Not that we should be just concerning ourselves with the goodness of a movie based on how much profit it made. I'm not a numbers guy, but you know, like the timing is everything.
That is,
you know?
Funny though, because a lot of the worst movies correlate to box office bombs.
Yeah, that is also true. It's also like the timing of when you release a movie also plays into public perception of like 100%. How good or bad something is.